Hello everybody, I'm Riccardo Tonini from Still Italiano Endodontics. I would like to share with you a story of two cases, two clinical cases that I found them really difficult to treat. Why? Because they are both internal and external resorptions, but I decided to manage them in two different ways. The first one, treating in one situation, so root canal treatment and after surgical treatment, and the second one exactly the opposite.
As you can see here in the medial part, we have an extremely aggressive external cervical resorption, and from CBCT we can appreciate that there is a communication between external and internal part. So basically these kind of teeth are completely asymptomatic usually, and in order to treat them in a proper way, we have to choose if start before with an endodontic treatment and after with a surgical treatment, or instead the opposite. In this case, example, I started with the conventional root canal treatment. So I decided to make an open anastasis cavity conventionally because honestly, it was my first experience with this kind of difficult situation. So absolutely, I was looking for something new. As you can see here, I removed all of the pulp chamber and I found the barrier that is placed between the pulp chamber and the periodontal ligament, so the bone from the external part. I decided to make a root canal treatment as a conventional and I removed this barrier and without destroying completely the tooth. So here I decided to clean perfectly all the lesion, to rinse, and I focused my attention more on root canal treatment. We have no risk of extrusion of apicolite because there is again a barrier with external bone. I made my root canal treatment and I decided to try to fill the lesion with MTA. It was my first experience, so with the MAP system, I placed the MTA in the internal part of this kind of lesion. I filled completely the initial aspect of the root canal system. And from the X-ray, I understood, okay, you filled maybe a part of the lesion, but you were not able to fill completely the external part. After 1 week, I decided in this way to reopen a flap and to reintervent to this tooth. So I open a flap, I remove some bone in the initial part, and as you can see here, the bone is growing inside the tooth. And it's impossible to identify the margin of the tooth. So it's impossible to find the line that separates the tooth from the bone, because we lose the periodontal ligament. I lost the periodontal ligament in this way. Considering that in my hands now I need a material that I can place perfectly and a material that can set immediately, I chose in this case a super EBA, but maybe you can choose also biodentin or a bioceramic material. In my opinion, not so much MTA because the washability of this of the material is high. Sure. The best way would be also to work with a composite, also if we consider the aesthetic point of view. But it was my first experience, so I was more focused on the reconstruction of this missing part. And with composite, we have also to manage humidity. If not, the risk is to fail double. So I removed the soft tissue, the inflammatory tissue with the ball, and I placed a super EBA in order to fill completely the situation. As you can see from the X-ray, you can appreciate that here inside there is my MTA, and here outside instead the super EBA. The most difficult thing is try to follow the original anatomy and not place the material all outside, because we are not able to identify where the root is. Following the patient in the next weeks, from a point of view, a status point of view, I'm looking for a better healing, but in any case, I was really satisfied for this result. And in the 3rd day, instead, I met another case, a similar case, and for this reason, I decided to start instead from a surgical point of view first. I opened a flap, and I removed all the bone that is growing inside. Here you can see perfectly what it means. You can see the bone that is growing inside the tooth, and you are not able to identify what is bone and what is tooth. So I tried to clean. I started cleaning everything, because you have to clean, and if you want to place in the proper way the material. But after a few minutes that I was cleaning perfectly, I found the communication way between pulp chamber and external part. So for sure, both cases needs a double treatment. But in this case, I decided to start instead from external part, from a surgical part, placing first super EBA, and here I found the best way for cleaning super EBA and for cleaning the margin with the sonic tip. After that, the material was completely set, I closed the flap, and I started the root canal treatment. Here, I started the root canal treatment. From this side, it seems a completely normal tooth, but it's not a normal tooth. So I make, in any case, a root canal treatment. I cleaned perfectly the communication way between internal and external parts. And at the end, I filled with a bulk composite. This is Irreflex, the new tips for the new tip made in polymer for a better cleaning, and you can clean and dip the deepest part of the root canal system without any problems, because the penetration on this tip is fantastic. The difficulty of this anatomy is that the major canals are really close to each other, but they are separate. Filling. After obturation, I filled completely with the bulk system in order to obtain a better result. Here. And the follow-up can show us that absolutely the management, in my opinion, in this case was also good. Okay, so what's the best way for treating this case? First surgical or first endo treatment? If it's asymptomatic, I understood that it is better to open the flap first, see the lesion, and try to fix the situation, external situation, immediately. But in the same appointment, you have to remove the inflammatory tissue, the pulp, because there is always a communication from the internal part and the external part. And a double treatment is required, and it's better to start from the surgical point of view first, and after make a root canal treatment. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and keep in touch, we see in the next appointment. Thanks so much. Let me know if you have any comments right below to this post.